I will make a presentation of the subsetting service using RDAP that we plan to install in the VRE. And this work has been done by Aurélie Briand and Léo Bruvry-Lagadec. I'm only reporting their work, and I will try to answer questions if there are any, but it's not my big specialty, RDAP. So RDAP, I would make a general presentation of RDAP, and I will describe some configuration for CDataNet in situ file and for CDataNet products, and give some information about RDAP. What is RDAP? RDAP is developed by NOAA, by a guy named Bob Simon, and it handles gridded data and in situ data. And this software allows to make temporal and spatial subsecting, and also you can select on several kind of parameters and so on. The users using the RDAP are able to download the data in many common file formats, and in order not to waste time in conversion of files. The RDAP software is free and reusable, and it is designed for web application and web services. It's kind of a middleman, and you can use your favorite client to get your data from many sources, and you can get data into many common programs and file types using RDAP. The subsetting give access to also other functions like discovery, subsetting, RDAP, RDAP gives access function like discovery, subsetting, visualization, and download. And you can download, as I just said before, data in many common file types, which can be netcdf, grip, CSV, and so on, and also image files when you are making graphs using RDAP. RDAP is used will be used as a subsetting service on the VRE data pools to support the VRE users. And we have made some improvement of the netcdf format in order to be compatible with RDAP. And one of the changes we had to make with Octopus is to, in Octopus and Nemo, is to generate netcdf file where the default value for all the parameters is the same, whatever the parameter is. So we have made this change in Octopus in order to be able to use the netcdf CDataNet files with RDAP. So RDAP is already provided in the VRE, as you may have seen yesterday, in a Docker container. And this is done for an easy deployment in the VRE cloud environment. At the moment, we have a pre-installed instance of RDAP software on a predefined subsetting, small subset of data, of CDataNet data, just for demonstration, because it's not yet operational. We are in a development phase of this product. So, but in the future, normally the user will be able to use RDAP to work on this, the data he has selected from the CDataNet web site and put in his workspace on the VRE. But at the moment, it's not working like that at all. We are just in the prototype phase. So using RDAP, you have a subsetting data access form where you can select different criteria for selecting data. And you can select, for example, if you have a set of data with several parameters, but you want to have the file containing only the salinity. You are not interested in the file which don't contain the salinity. Then you can make this kind of selection using RDAP. At the moment, RDAP is based on the list of parameters that you have in your netcdf file. So that are the P01 parameters. And we want to change that and to improve RDAP in order to be able to make a request on the P02 parameters, which means that if you want to have, for example, data with temperature in it, you don't need to know which code, which P01 code of temperature has been used by the user. You would like to select all the files with temp, P02 temp in it. So, but this development of RDAP is not yet available. We are working with Bob Simon to implement it. And this will be done in the next release, maybe. So with RDAP, you are able to see this kind of map where you have your data set that you have in the VRE, and you can draw this kind of map. You can draw also, you can zoom on a specific section or on a specific profile. RDAP is also configured for the CDataNet product. It can give access to users to the climatology which have been developed in the frame of CData Cloud using the netcdf DIVA files. And it works also, it could work also on the aggregated data collection, but at the moment these collections are very big and too big for RDAP, so maybe we will have to split the file. We don't know yet how to manage this, because for example the aggregated data set for the North Atlantic contains a lot of profiles, and this is too much for RDAP at the moment. So, and already in the CDataNet website, if you go to the product page and to the product description, you have this small button of on the right of the screen where you can download the data. And if you look at the menu under this button, you can access the full collection data set, or you can accept to the data using RDAP subsecting service. If you click on this button on the menu, you will arrive on this kind of screen, which is the RDAP screen, where you can select, you can make some subsetting on the climatology in that case. And you can, for example, make a graph using RDAP, and you will happen to this kind of figures. So, for the CDataNet products, we need to implement the Marine ID authentication, which is not yet implemented. So this will be done soon, I guess. And if we look at RDAP provide access to RESTful services. It means that the URL of RDAP completely defines the data you want in the format you want. I will demonstrate that later on. And we can use as output format of RDAP the GeoCision output, which means that the output can be used for visualization of data. And I will also demonstrate that later on. So this is done to quickly plug the provided data source in a web portal. It can be used implementing OpenLayers, Leaflet, or Google Map GIS layers. So we have been developing a VisualOcean tool prototype on top of RDAP, because RDAP is not a very beautiful visualization tool. So we can use RDAP to send the data via a more beautiful visualization tool. And we did that using RDAP RESTful services based on JavaScript mapping library and iCharts to draw the graph from the RDAP JSON output. And we have managed to have this kind of interface where on the on the left, you can see there is a link to RDAP. And from there, this link, you go back to the selection, to the selection windows of RDAP, which is plugged on your CDataNet set in the VRE. This is the future, of course. At the moment, it's a fixed data set. So, and from with this tool, you can select some parameters or whatever. And so first you select the option for the subsetting, and you have some mandatory fields to be selected, which are listed on this slide. Then you select the JSON output for RDAP. And then you copy the URL in the field. You submit it to your to the tools that we have developed, and you will have the visualization tool with the CDataNet dataset. And if you click on one specific station, you can visualize the profile. Or if it is a time series, you can visualize the time series. I think that's more or less all. This is to announce that in the future, as I said before, we will plug RDAP on a SDN dataset saved in the VRE of the workspace of the user. And now the user will be able to navigate in his file using the file selector on the left screen. But at the moment, it's not yet there. So I can suggest you to do some test of RDAP if you would like. You can connect to the VRE where you were yesterday. The address is http://orca.dkrz.dd, yes, I think. And I will do it at the same time than you. So in this VRE, we have put a data set. We have put a data set which is composed of more than 500 local CDI IDs of tight gauge, current meters, XBT, thermosaligraph, and bottle. So if we go in the VRE, here we are. Here you have the RDAP facility, so you can click on it. There you have to go to view the dataset that we have put in this RDAP container, and you have the CDataNet in situ data. So if you click, for example, on data here, you will have a graph. A selection interface. Can I put this on my? It's difficult for me to on the screen here. I don't see the same screen. You see, I need to close that maybe. Escape or something. No. Yes, it's behind. Yeah. Thank you. So there you have to select. By default, everything is selected. You can see the blue check there. So you uncheck everything. Where is uncheck all? Here. You click on uncheck all. And you select only the mandatory fields are the local CDI ID, the depth, for example, the latitude, the longitude, the time. These are the metadata of the station, the time. And if we want only the station, for example, with salinity and oxygen, I don't know, why not? And I want only the station having this data, so I say salinity must be different of nothing, which is N-A-N, with the N, capital N-A, it's not an A, A-N, And also with oxygen must be different from nothing. Up. This is RDAP way of selecting data. And by default, RDAP put a very small time scale, so I will enlarge it to select all the time scale of the data set. And I will say, tell RDAP I want to have the result as an HTML page. And I ask him to generate the corresponding URL. And I submit my request. So now I have all the stations with salinity and oxygen from my dataset. So it's a way to select on parameters. We don't have that in the CDI interface. We can probably do the same thing with using Ocean Data View, I don't know. But at least with this, we have a possible selection on the parameters. And there I have extracted the data at the HTML format, but I could have chosen another format, like for example, the CSV format. Up. And if I submit my request, I can open probably maybe I should, yes, I can open the CSV file containing all my data. And you have several output formats like that. So that was a small demonstration, and I want to show you also the visualization tools that I just talked about. So it's connected to RDAP. This one is not in the VRE yet. It's a prototype and you cannot use it at the moment. But it's just to show you it's plugged on the same data set that the one which is in the VRE. If I go back to RDAP, and I make a selection. Again, I will take the local CDI ID, the depth, the latitude, the longitude, the time, and I will take all the time. And this time I want to, I don't know, to see only the sea level data, so I will take only the sea level. And I will say that I want the sea level to be not null. So different of land. And I will, as I want to take this data back to my visualization interface, I will select an output JSON format. Here, and I will generate the URL. I will copy paste this URL here. No, I would like to copy paste, but is it control or CMD?
Command.
Command.
Yeah.
Okay. So now.
And then command V.
Yes. So I copied the URL and I submit it to my visualization tool. And now I should have only the current, the sea level data. Oh. I need to zoom out because I know they are in the, yes, in the South Indian Ocean. And here, if I click on one data set, for example, I can see my sea level data. And it's this local CDI ID is there. The date of the beginning of the series, the EDMO code, the cruise reference, and the data type. And here I have the sea level in function of time. and more or less it's what I wanted to show you. So it's not yet available, this kind of tool in the VRE. It should be later on, but we still have a lot of work to do to achieve that. I don't know if you have any questions concerning AirDAP and
Is there something that we should do from our side to allow AirDAP to work? Put data into NetCDF or something like that? Or is that something which will be done at the VRE level?
I think that at least if you are working on your own data set coming from CDataNet, you have to have it at NetCDF format. CDataNet, NetCDF format in your VRE. So I don't know yet how this will be done, but if you are working with the CDI selection, and you will extract some data at NetCDF format. And once it will be in the VRE, so I guess there you can work with AirDAP on this data set. At least it is the aim of this tool. Mm-hmm. Yes?
What you just showed about visualization, especially this application resembles what Giorgio presented yesterday, and the previous visualization with the interpolated map resembles the DIVA software. Can we combine the two, and what is the added value of either this or the DIVA / Deltares development, if you already have the other?
Yeah, I think I'm not able to answer this question. I think this one is another visualization tool linked to AirDAP, which can help you to easy select parameters. That's important because the subsetting on parameter values is not, I don't know about the Deltares tool. Can you subset, if you have a data set, can you say, I just want the oxygen in this data set, for example? I don't think so. So this is something else, something on top of it, something more, let's say. And concerning the map I showed before using in the presentation, you are talking about the, when we were working on I was showing the AirDAP on the DIVA map. It was just to show that it's possible to do it, but actually it works on DIVA I've done the maps before. It's already gridded data provided by DIVA, which are underneath under AirDAP. It's not the data in situ data themselves. But that means, for example, if you are working on this using AirDAP on the DIVA climatology, you can reduce the geographic area. You can select only one parameter, not salinity, only temperature. You can work on the small zone. This AirDAP is a subsetting software in that case.
Okay.